This simple duo for violin and piano from our first CD marks, in a mysterious way, the beginning of Inside I'm Singing. How? Well, we must roll back to 1998, to a restaurant in the west of Ireland. One particular night, while playing our CD as background, one special guest, Barbra Streisand, heard our music, liked it a lot, and took the album home. Back in LA, she contacted us with the news that she was going to perform one of our songs with newly added lyrics at her own wedding. The song was Heartstrings. Her version became known as I've Dreamed of You.
I've dreamed of you, always feeling well there. And all my life I have searched for you everywhere.
We think of this story as the true seeds to Inside I'm Singing. Barbra Streisand was the first artist to discover the natural affinity between our instrumental music and singers. Many artists have since transformed our music, and so, 15 years later, we decided to invite some of our favourite singers to make an album with us, an album of songs. Inside I'm Singing.
Just a key change.
I think the interesting thing is that if you can keep it very Irish with the Irish ornaments and play it in a very traditional way, I think it's, you know, it's very.
We started to develop the album by rearranging some of our old melodies, favourites like Nocturne, Song from a Secret Garden, Ode to Simplicity, Passacaglia, and Hymn to Hope. All were transformed into vocal arrangements. Each of these songs already had their own story embedded through years of performance. We wanted to protect the Secret Garden identity and at the same time allow the artists to give the songs their own signature. Our challenge was to find the right words, create the best arrangements and choose the perfect voice for each song.
That's very good. We have two good choices there. First part was gorgeous. There was a bit of a bow squeak there in the end.
Once again, we turned to Brendan Graham to join forces with us.
So I usually put the idea.
He'd previously written the words to songs like You Raise Me Up, Sleep Song, and Always There. And so it was a natural creative choice to invite him on board for this project.
When I get melodies, what I'm hearing on the melody from Rolf is Fionnuala and her violin. And I often think that she is already the voice of the song, the way she expresses it and the way the violin moves and the way it flows up and down with the emotions. So to me, in a way, my job is simple then, because she's the voice and she has already laid out the way this is to be sung. So I am really then trying to find lyrics or words that will sit with her voice and the voice of the melody.
We chose Sanden Studio in Kristiansand as our home base for the recording and mixing of this album. It's a natural choice for us as most of our band live in Kristiansand. It also hosts its own great symphony orchestra and is a general hub for many wonderful musicians. Rolf is very comfortable producing in this studio and has a close working relationship built over the years with sound engineer Roald Rosberg.
One bar.
Rolf did all the orchestral scoring and conducting, and the Kristiansand Symphony Orchestra accompanied all the songs with Rolf's new arrangements. extension, Abbey Road Studio in London, and musicians the world over dream of having a chance to record there.
It's not a chord there, it's...
Steeped in history, music seems to be embedded in its very walls. You can almost hear and feel the echo of the Beatles resounding throughout the building. It's very special for us to have the Abbey Road ambience become part of our music.
Okay, here it comes.
Having the chance to record there with Tracy Campbell and the London Gospel Choir was our dream come true. Both Tracy and the choir had featured on our original recording of You Raise Me Up in 2001. It felt right to invite these amazing artists back to be part of this album on Sometimes a Prayer Will Do. Sometimes you'll be
I've been a fan of Secret Garden from the last album where we did You Raise Me Up, and I started to get the albums and get involved with their music, and I was really honoured and excited when I got the email to say, can you come down and demo a track, and even more ecstatic when they said they wanted me to do it. So I'm over the moon because I love the music. It's brilliant. Brilliant. Then we are stronger.
Somehow we know we will get through to face the future. Sometimes a prayer will do. Sometimes a prayer will do. Yeah. Sometimes a prayer will do. Sometimes a prayer will do.
I hope I bring a lot of things to the table for him, and I certainly as a melody writer, it's just so wonderful still, even in this day and age, that to have somebody with Rob's talent in terms of writing the just the beautiful melodies he does, which are able to communicate anywhere in the world. The first public outing of this Inside I'm Singing album was a TV performance of Thank You at the Norwegian Grammy Awards show. We invited the Swedish singer Peter Jobo to come on stage with us. Peter was one of the original singers in the musical Christina, written by Björn Ulvaeus and Benny Andersson of ABBA. Thank You is one of the new songs that was written especially for this album, a song about gratitude, expressing the words we sometimes forget to say.
I just want to say it. Thank you for each day with you.
Bransjeprisen 2007 går til Rolf Løvland.
This Grammy performance of Thank You also coincided with Rolf receiving an achievement award from the Norwegian Grammy jury in recognition of his international success as a composer. That includes 2 Eurovision wins and the Secret Garden song You Raise Me Up, which has reached over 500 cover versions with 1 million airplay rotations on American radio to date. It was an emotional moment for Rolf when the entire audience representing the Norwegian music industry gave him a standing ovation. On Inside I'm Singing, we also included 2 instrumental pieces. Back in 2006, we recorded the original soundtrack composed by Rolf for an American film starring Kim Basinger called The Mermaid's Chair. The music has never previously been released, and we felt it was right to air this track on the CD. The opening title song, theme from The Mermaid's Chair, is a slow pas de deux to the beautiful dance of the mermaids. In 2001, we recorded You Raise Me Up. In many ways, it has become our signature song with more than 500 different recordings with artists like Josh Groban, Westlife, Kenny G, Il Divo, and Aretha Franklin. It's now been played more than 1 million times on American radio, Grammy nominated with Josh Groban, and UK Single of the Year with Westlife. The song has been performed at the Super Bowl in commemoration of the NASA astronauts in the Columbia Space Shuttle tragedy. It's been a part of the 9/11 ceremonies in New York, was performed at legendary George Best's funeral, and at the Nelson Mandela 90th anniversary in Madison Square Garden. You Raise Me Up has become our most important song, and it felt only natural to include the original recording on this vocal album. Soon after its release in Norway, Inside I'm Singing went to number 1 on the national charts, and within 6 weeks of its release, it had reached platinum status 4 times over and went on to become the best-selling album of the year. In Korea, Secret Garden's audiences took the album to number 1 in retail already on the first week of sales. We loved making this album and are very excited with all the amazing artists who have signed their names to our music. And for Secret Garden to be able to work with legends like Barbra Streisand, Elaine Page, Tommy Kirbeck and so many others is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity and a wonderful celebration of 15 years working together.
To more than